The Power Rangers!
Just keep rolling.
What is up, people? This is Al DeTinci with another installment of On the Brain. Now, today we're going to talk about something fun and something that may or may not start arguments, depending on what side you're on.
Is it fun?
No! Adaptations. And when I say adaptations, you know, the most common ones are TV shows into movies.
No advertising!
Comics into movies. Or remakes of something that was once a cartoon and or movie, they get turned into something else.
I don't know.
Books, comic books, video games, you know, all that crap. Now, so far, there hasn't really been that many good ones, in my opinion, anyway.
Somebody's raising their hand.
Now, we got my boy Vile-Rex.
I believe in episode 31/A, On the Rain, that we did discuss this. We discussed remakes when it came to horror movies and Over Yonder stuff.
Yeah, that was a horror movie discussion.
Oh, yeah.
Now we're talking about adaptations, period.
Word.
Now, where's my therapist?
It seems like, well, dude, you need more than therapy. But it seems like today Hollywood has definitely run out of original ideas and just turned into a, you know, let's turn this property into this, let's do this with this, blah 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 blah, you know. Like, for example, X-Men Origins, Spider-Man, you know, the common ones. And now I recently heard that they're going to do a Green Lantern movie. You know what was a great Green Lantern movie? This one was a great Green Lantern movie.
For no advertising.
Okay? That was a great movie. But I heard that they're actually going to do a live-action adaptation to that. What do you think about that, Bio-Rex?
Do what you got to do, but please don't get Ryan Reynolds to play it. Please.
You heard that Ryan Reynolds was going to play Green Lantern?
Yes, I have.
And how do you think he's going to do?
Not as good as he was playing Deadpool.
He was silent playing Deadpool.
It wasn't? Did you not see X-Men Origins?
No. I mean, like, when he got turned into Deadpool, he was silent during that whole thing.
Yeah, but your point being, he was a great Wade Wilson.
Okay.
He was a good Hannibal King. Mm-hmm. Just stick to one thing, Ryan. Please. Don't be Halle Berry. Don't go from a good role as Storm to a sour milk role like Catwoman, okay? You were good as Hannibal King. You were phenomenal as Deadpool for your 12 seconds. But, please. No Green Lantern, no Flash.
I didn't even bother to see Catwoman. I like
how... What about 9,000 other people with the same idea?
But I didn't even bother to see Catwoman because, I don't know, it just didn't really look that...
Catwoman's not black. I'm not biracial.
Actually, I think she looked pretty nice in the Catwoman
suit. Yeah! But she's also another dominatrix.
She is not hot!
Excuse me,
that's
another subject right there. I'm not allowed to debate Halle Berry with you. I'm not going to debate this on this episode. It's not, you know.
No,
it's
she
not.
Was good as Storm, but she sucked as Catwoman.
Mm-hmm. So you saw the movie?
No. Mm. But I've heard a lot. I wouldn't see it because she was black.
Now, alright, now what movie adaptations do you actually think are, you know, okay, decent, nice, you know, great? Any ones that you think are great, first of all?
X-Men 1 and 2.
Right.
Spider-Man 1 and 2 were
right.
Good adaptations.
Good.
X-Men 3 sucked. Spider-Man 3 sucked. Iron Man.
Was an awesome.
Awesome movie.
Iron Man was awesome.
Mr. Downey Jr., phenomenal role.
Can't wait for Iron Man 2.
Other adaptations.
You can put books
in. Just don't make video games in the movies, please. Stop.
Or
Hollywood, if you're watching, please, stop. You're ruining it.
Yeah, worst ones being... Anybody remember Super Mario Brothers?
No, and I try not to. Only decent adaptation from a video game into a movie was Mortal Kombat. Because all it was pointless fighting.
Well, because Mortal Kombat was, you know, they
pointless
actually
fighting.
Did what they were setting out.
Resident Evil sucked.
Right.
All three of them. House of the Dead sucked.
They totally strayed away from the original plotline.
Mario Brothers sucked.
Mm.
Tekken... I haven't seen Period School before. I heard about Tekken. It's not going to do good.
All right. I've seen pictures of Tekken. It looked decent, but it still looks like a bunch of people cosplaying to me. You know, it doesn't really look that nasty.
Exactly. Street Fighter was a fucking car wreck. So was Chun-Li.
Yeah, dude. I already did a video about that, and a lot of people either said yes, and a lot of people either said no, and I'm sorry for getting some names mixed up.
What is another adaptation that fucking blew worse than fucking Monica Lewinsky?
What did you think of Tomb Raider?
Horrible.
The first one was alright.
Horrible.
The first one was okay.
Oh, come on, Angelina Jolie, dude, they pretty much filmed those cave sequences in between her legs.
Yeah, you know, I can't really argue with that.
Okay, then.
What about Doom.
Doom.
Alright, what else?
Dragon Ball. I don't like Dragon Ball Z whatsoever. I'm not a huge fan of it. But come on. You guys raped it.
Dude.
Hollywood raped that.
Yeah,
I don't even like him named Goku.
Because they didn't care about Dragon Ball in the first place. They even said it later on. They just slapped they just slapped the script together. That's why the whole thing was just out of whack.
And they got King of Fighters coming out.
Yeah, they got King of Fighters
coming out. They got a white dude playing the lead role. He's Japanese.
Yeah. What about that, that Ninja Warrior movie that's coming out soon?
Ninja Assassin?
Yeah, Ninja Assassin. Was that based off of anything? That looks like it was based off of something.
I don't know, I'll be honest.
Because I seriously think Hollywood has lost its originality.
Hell yeah.
Y'all tell me what you guys think, because this was actually a heated discussion we had a while ago.
Now they're making stuff out of toys, like Transformers, G.I. Joe, before you know they got My Little Pony, Barbie's Dream House.
No, guess what they got coming out soon, though?
The Sims.
Stretch Armstrong and The Sims. Stretch Armstrong.
Shenanigans.
The Sims?
Shenanigans. How the fuck are you going to make Sims into a movie?
It's actually easy, because playing The Sims is like making your own movie anyway.
Yeah, but what's the point?
I don't know.
It's ridiculous.
It's another way to make money.
I don't care.
I mean either, but it's another way to make money. That's why they're doing what they're doing. Like the comic book adaptation.
I'm just waiting for them to make Madden 2010 into a movie.
That would just be a football movie. We got enough.
Yeah, Howard wants to make a bunch called Madden. Madden the movie.
Yeah, but you gotta get the actual. What's his name?
John Madden.
To actually be in the movie and
actually hire an actor.
Because that's his name.
So you hire an actor. You know what I mean? Like Beckham had nothing to do with David Beckham.
What did they get? They said bend it like Beckham. They didn't say something about Beckham.
Alright, play it like Madden.
Oh, that's just lame.
Play it like Madden.
You know what I think they should do? I think if you're gonna adapt something, Don't completely stray away from what it's supposed to be. A Madden is just a sports game. If they would have made something out of a sports game, it really wouldn't make any sense, because we got enough sports movies as it is.
True.
So what the heck would be the point? You know, what next? Gran Turismo?
Grand Theft Auto, actually.
Grand Theft Auto. Ooh.
That was actually a movie back in the 80s. Remember that?
It was?
Yeah. Robert.
Oh, really? Yeah. So was the game based off of the...
No.
At all? No. I had no idea. Grand Theft Auto ain't really my game.
You know something good adaptation thing about it?
What?
Watchmen.
Watchmen was awesome.
Watchmen 300.
Watchmen...
Zack Snyder, you are a genius.
Awesome. Right direction, right story.
When you want to make an adaptation, you're going to get a director who's like... knows what the fans are
familiar with what he or she has.
Look at Batman. Batman Begins and The Dark Knight were phenomenal because you have a director who wanted to give the fans what they wanted.
Spider-Man 1 and 2. Dark Knight.
Yeah, Spider-Man 1 and 2. You had a director, Sam Raimi, who wanted to give the fans what they wanted. And look how successful they were. Spider-Man 3 rolls around. Well, you know, fuck the fans. I'll do it my way. I'll put Sandman in there. No one gives a rat's ass about Sandman. Nobody does. They were the only one to see Venom and the New Goblin. That's all the fans want to see. They had half the movie was based on Sandman, and you know what? He's a nobody. Sandman was a waste, and it ruined the movie. It honestly ruined the movie. You want to focus your time on Harry Osborn and Peter, Eddie Brock versus Peter.
And
you don't want to just throw this one guy in there. We know who shot him. We honestly all know who shot Uncle Ben. It was a guy in the first movie. They would have mentioned the other. They just threw a stupid plot together, which was fucking ridiculous. The movie was stupid. So I didn't think it was horrible. Sandman, go fuck yourself.
I actually did enjoy some parts of Spider-Man 3,
it's called the end credits.
But the thing about it was, I thought they just too many villains in it.
Yeah, exactly. You had too many characters to focus on. That was X-Men 3's downfall. You had X-Men 1, which was good. 2 was awesome. 3, you killed off Cyclops right in the first 10 minutes. Sorry for those who didn't see the movie. You killed off Professor X. Mm-hmm. You brought in all these new... You pretty much got rid of Rogue to bring in Shadowcat. You brought in all these new villains, you brought in all these new characters, it was not enough time to focus on everyone.
And same thing they did with Transformers when they,
Transformers 1 was awesome. Part 2, you brought in, like, 15 Transformers.